Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I rise today to call for an immediate end to President Trump's irresponsible and unnecessary government shutdown, which has now entered its 26th day. People in my home state of New Hampshire and across this country are suffering, and they are put at risk because of this manufactured crisis. One woman wrote into my office, "My two girls and I count on the auto deposit from their dad. If this goes on, we will not be able to buy food, pay bills, or buy gasoline." Another constituent wrote, "We are not okay with a shutdown for a wall or for any other reason. We are not pawns on a chessboard." The wife of a Coast Guard member spoke of the sacrifices that their family has already made for this country, and now they are facing the uncertainty of even being able to pay their mortgage. We take an oath to protect and defend this country. Safety is our number one job. And yet, air traffic controllers, TSA agents, DEA agents, and even, ironically, Border Patrol agents are not receiving their pay, and our safety is at risk. One of the most heartrending stories that I've heard is that domestic violence shelters in New Hampshire and across this country are cutting services to women and children whose lives are at risk. And these stories go on and on. They speak to the reality of who in our society is truly being hurt by President Trump's shutdown. Women and children, seniors and veterans, whose health and safety and well-being is put at risk by his intransigence. We here in the House have voted repeatedly to reopen the government, and the Senate should follow suit. I urge the President to end this shutdown so we can focus on the hard work that is expected of us by the American people. Democrats and Republicans in this Congress agree we need comprehensive immigration reform and 21st century border security. Now is the time to reopen the government so that we can work together in good faith to advance meaningful legislation that will strengthen and protect our country. Mr. McConnell, President Trump, do your job. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I yield back the balance of my time. Members.